I too rise to oppose this budget this year. For 3 years, we've seen Corbett budget after Corbett budget that has been more of the same. More of the same in that we proudly say that it's balanced and on time. And if that's the standard, well, I guess this governor's doing okay. But if the standard is 600,000-700,000 people who aren't going to receive Medicaid, well, then it's a total failure. If the standard is that we don't have schools that are falling apart, that we don't have our largest city begging for help and instead being provided illusory opportunities to tax themselves out of any chance of lifting themselves up. They call them stress schools. I guess that stands for Senate Republican Senate schools, because they don't reflect those schools that need help the most. They reflect those school districts that have senators who happen to be of the party opposite. That is no way to fund education in Pennsylvania. It is simply wrong. This is a budget that says a block grant system that cynically pits our most vulnerable against each other, that says those programs for our most vulnerable should compete against each other for limited dollars, dollars that were cut 10% last year and are not in any way funded at adequate levels again this year. That's not compassion, that's cynicism at its height. It is bad public policy. But it's not bad public policy in itself, it's bad public policy because it's based on the same failed idea that more corporate welfare, that a cracker plant that is yet to come in existence, will provide real help to Pennsylvania's workers. We can't do Medicaid, we can't do transportation, but we've got plenty of money for corporate welfare, for multinational corporations who can't pay a severance tax, but can put their hand out for more corporate tax cuts. We can't do a Delaware loophole close. We can't fund the accountability block grant. No, we can say it's on this illusory stimulus argument, and I respect the majority appropriations chair greatly, but let's not kid ourselves, the 08-09 budget numbers, stimulus didn't exist, and the budget numbers for our school districts were higher then than they are today. We can kid ourselves and blame the federal government, but the problem is two floors to our bottom. A governor who thinks that the standard is balanced and on time. A governor who can't deliver on transportation for our failing roads. A governor who has been completely unable to deal with higher education cuts. We pride ourselves on our commitment to education. Stimulus dollars not accounted for, we are down 19% on our commitment to higher ed. But then we wonder why we are the highest state in the Commonwealth in terms of student debt. Our legacy to our children is failed K-12 schools and more debt for higher ed. That is no legacy for this governor, but that is his legacy. And that's what he's going to have to go to the voters and show. He's going to have to explain why his policies have resulted in struggling test scores, school districts that have to come here every year, and more joining the line every year, who need desperately handouts from this body rather than a real funding system. We don't do a shale tax. We say, tax yourselves. This isn't a statewide program. This is the third budget in a failed regime that has provided failed leadership that has not worked for Pennsylvania. We need a no on this budget, and we need new leadership from the governor.